All right. Good evening, headbangers. Had a great night last night. What better thing to do on a Wednesday night than to go to the Glass House in Pomona and see Zakk Wylde do his Zakk Sabbath show. Man, what a treat. Thanks to Brian Sevilla for the invite. Go check out his channel. He's got a good channel there going too. We've done a couple of videos together at Power Trip, and he's a good dude. Anyway, we got in about an hour early, and we went right up to the balcony to get kind of that nice little down view, and it's amazing. If you get a chance to go see Zakk Wylde do his Zakk Sabbath thing, you gotta go. You just gotta go. I got a lot of good stories with Black Sabbath and Ozzy. The first time I saw Ozzy was in 1992 in November, and it was his No More Tours tour where he was supposedly hanging it up. Yeah, right. You know, everyone kind of does that. I still have the t-shirt too. It's cool. It's like a glow-in-the-dark one, and he's like biting a, you know, a dove or something, and it's pretty cool. That was a really epic show. Very historical. Black Sabbath opened up for Ozzy at the time. Zakk Wylde, of course, was there. He was amazing. Last minute, Ronnie James Dio quit, and Rob Halford came in, and Rob Halford sang all the Black Sabbath songs with Tony Iommi, Geezer Butler, Bill Ward, and it was fucking awesome. There's a couple grainy VHS tapes out there. Someone copied or taped that and got it on the internet, and thank God they did. It was kind of like a historic thing. That was my first time seeing Ozzy, and he's pouring buckets of water on the crowd. And at the end of the show, you know, he came out and he had Sharon with him and Kelly and Jack, and they were like little kids on the stage. It was super cool. The most recent time I saw Black Sabbath and Ozzy was about 10 years ago. I'm wearing the shirt from that show at the Hollywood Bowl. Went with my son, Julian, and man, that was a treat. That was so amazing just to see Black Sabbath, you know, doing their thing. It was like totally awesome. Had a good evening. So let's talk about the Glass House a little bit in Pomona. Historical, kind of little hole in the wall off of 2nd Street in Pomona. A lot of bands have played there. My friend George, hey George, saw Tool there in 1992. Like, wow, that's amazing. But Rage Against the Machine has played there, Jane's Addiction. There's so many historical bands. It's just a cool place to go. If you ever get a chance to go to the Glass House in Pomona, I would do it. On to the show. Let's talk about the show here. Zakk Sabbath, man, so entertaining, so fun. You know, his voice sounds a lot like Ozzy, like early Ozzy, Black Sabbath, Volume 4, you know, Black Sabbath, like, you know, the real down and dirty Ozzy. He sounds a lot like him. It's kind of uncanny. I think it's funny that, you know, he sent a demo tape to Ozzy, you know, and then became, you know, his main acts, you know, for decades, you know, on and off here and there. But I mean, if Ozzy was to play tomorrow, you know, Zakk would be there too. You know, he sounded great. It was awesome just watching him. He kind of improvises a little bit on the guitars as he goes. He puts his own little spin on things. My favorite part, and don't miss this, is towards the end of the video, is when Zakk goes into the crowd and then he goes back on stage. Then he sneaks out the side and he comes up to the balcony right where I am. And security pushes me and my son away, and Zach's right there and he's playing guitar where I was standing, sweat dripping all over the place, playing a guitar solo, looking down over the crowd from the balcony, putting the guitar behind his head. It's fucking epic. Don't miss it. Skip to it if you want to. I don't care if you don't watch the rest of the video. Watch that part of it for sure. You know, he was awesome, you know, with his Gibson Les Paul, you know, signature purple black guitar. It was amazing. Setlist: Supernaut, Snowblind, Lord of This World, Under the Sun, Tomorrow's Dream, Wicked World, Fairies Wear Boots, everyone singing along, Into the Void, Children of the Grave, A National Acrobat, Hand of Doom, Behind the Wall of Sleep, NIB, and ended it with War Pigs. And that was amazing. Man, it was so good. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the show. We'll be right back.
according to each other. Therefore, Zakk Sabbath will continue touring on the Eternal College Fund Tour. I give you the one, the only, the Dennis Kahn of Zakk Sabbath. Father Joseph, the Cannonball. The City of
here's a small little taste of some of my rock and roll memorabilia. But yes, I'm a massive Ozzy fan. Of course I am. I got a couple autographs. My friend Dean gave this to me a long time ago from a photo shoot he did. Patient number 9 autographed. Yeah, I am definitely an Ozzy fan. One day I'll give a full tour of my office, but this is just kind of some of my little items here.